you have an interest in self-help, then this episode of the Comeback Coach podcast is for you. But if you have an interest in Neville Goddard and his teachings, then this episode is especially for you because our special guest is Carl Bradbrook. Now, Carl Bradbrook is a Neville Goddard expert. He's actually my go-to guide for all of Neville Goddard's teachings. Carl Bradbrook is a relentless seeker of the wisdom and has participated in just about every form of personal development modality available. Also attended meditation retreats in Asia and has participated in more Western-style processes and techniques than you can poke a stick at. He's also a master practitioner of NLP. He's a timeline therapist and clinical hypnotherapist, and he's produced a variety of personal development products. He's recorded a number of audiobooks, and he's currently teaching people how to communicate more effectively with their higher self and unconscious mind and become more of who they really are. Please sit back, enjoy watching or listening to this conversation I recorded with Carl Bradbrook, Neville Goddard expert.
Now it's my pleasure to bring to you Carl Bradbrook. Carl, welcome to the show.
Hey Mike, how you doing? Great to be here. Really, really excited about this.
Well, I'm really excited too. This is a special moment because you and I go back, 7 or 8 years.
Yeah.
And I first came to know of Carl Bradbrook when I was in the early stages of getting into and studying Neville Goddard's works. And that's how I stumbled across you. And I'd really like to spend some more time on that during our conversation. But the audience knows about what you're about through the introduction.
Yep.
And they know that you teach clients how to communicate more effectively with the higher self and the unconscious mind. But, of course, that didn't start out with where you are right now. Life for Carl began in England. Can you take us back to the earlier days for Carl Bradbrook? Because setting the backstory helps to set the direction for where we're going with the conversation.
Okay, so so that's reaching back a long way. I think really I left England when I was 24 and I went to Australia and I went on a backpacking holiday, and prior to that I'd been in the banking and finance world, and when I got to Australia I did what backpackers do for a while and ran out of money and then had to get a job, and I went back into banking and finance. And I did that for about something like all up, I think it was about 11 years with a couple of little breaks in the middle of it. So that was fundamentally what I was doing. And then, like a lot of people in that industry, the wheels fell off. And that really was the beginning of my journey. And I know you're the comeback coach, so this is going to be quite relevant. So my initial comeback, one day I was in Tokyo and I couldn't get out the front door of my house. And I was absolutely full of fear. And I just literally, I couldn't get out the front door of my house. And that was when I quit all of the drinking and all of the crazy partying and stuff like that. And that really was the beginning of my journey. And that was in 1995. And from there, I picked up, somebody sent me a book, a friend sent me a book. It was to do with Superlearning. I think that was my first self-help book. And I dived into that, and I dived into AA. And that was really an incredible support system. And it was my first introduction to something which is so relevant in the world today, which is handed our will and our lives over to a power greater than ourselves so that we could restore sanity into our lives. That's essentially one of the steps in AA. And that is the theme which is carried through, and that is the theme of the higher self. It's something, it's that greater part of ourselves, which we are. And then we're here also in our conscious mind, our ego cells. So that was really the start of the journey. And I was in there for a while. And that got me into self-help. And then after that, I started, I couldn't work in the financial markets anymore. And I started doing odd jobs, window cleaning. And I put on a headset and I got myself a Walkman. And and I called it my like sort of open university. So I clean windows and I'd listen to self-help all day long, all night long, and just completely absorbed it. And that was the turning point in my life. And then I had another crash, fell off the wagon for about a year and a half, and it reduced my life to absolute chaos. Ended up at my parents' house. And so then I was to come back again. And at that point, what really helped me was subliminal programs. So I did subliminal programs night and day and just bombarded my unconscious mind with a whole bunch of information. And that got me out of the UK again and back to Australia. And that really was the turning point where I started to get more deeply into self-help and started to get involved in helping some other people, did a bit of copywriting and helped a few other people and started my own website selling subliminal programs. And what really you mentioned and what really was a turning point, I had this essence of the higher self, but what was a real turning point for me was my introduction to Neville Goddard. And I noticed you interviewed Joe Vitale. And funnily enough, Joe Vitale was my introduction to Neville Goddard.
Really?
Because I bought a program from him, and it was called Attract a Car. And I actually attracted like a ride in a luxury car, and I stayed in a nice hotel. I got a chauffeur-driven car using the methods in his Attract a Car. And there was a bonus in there. And the bonus was some lectures by Neville Goddard and At Your Command, the book. And I looked around on the net, and I'd recorded some audiobooks before that, and there was nothing. Nobody had recorded any of this Neville Goddard stuff, and it was really scant on the internet. I think it was two websites doing it, and they were selling lectures for $20 a lecture. Yeah. And so I thought, right, I've got to record this. So I recorded At Your Command. I recorded what's called class instruction. Joe Vitale got one of the original booklets from the series of lectures that Neville did in 1948 called Class Instruction. And I recorded that, and that was really the beginning of that Neville Goddard journey. So from there, it was really a matter of following along on that and then just following my heart. And I've really been led down the path of the higher self. And that has really defined my journey. It's become stronger and stronger as I've moved forwards. Does that kind of answer your question there?
Yes,
just wondering.
Yes, Don't you worry about that, Carl. That answers it perfectly. I'll tell you why. Yes, this is the Comeback Coach podcast. Yes, we are talking to Carl Bradbrook, a healthy guy living his life today, helping others effectively communicate with their higher self and unconscious mind. And how does he do that? Well, Carl has a number of programs and courses and media that he uses, which we'll come back to later on as well. But Carl, let me tell you, as one former AA guy to another, I am so happy and grateful that you and I reached past that adversity that had us.
Yeah.
And I know all about it. And somebody could be listening to you right now, Carl, or watching you on YouTube. They could be caught in the grips of heavy drinking or problem drinking or straight out alcoholism right now. And this could be the catalyst, but we don't know who this will reach.
Yeah.
I know you will have done some mind work, and I certainly have, that this will reach the right person at the right time. And it will. And
So
if that's you in the audience right now watching Carl or listening to Carl on this interview, and you have it, or if it's not something to do with an addiction or addictive behavior, if it's some other issue, listen more deeply to what Carl has to say. Because he's been there, he's done that cliche, but he's made his comeback at more than once. And no one said the comeback has to be perfect. It's progress, not perfection, right? So, Carl.
Absolutely, yeah.
So Carl, all right, so originally from England, in the financial markets, left the financial markets, and through adversity, the seed was your introduction to elements of self-help in a spiritual sense, in an esoteric sense, in a metaphysical sense. And this has consumed you. This has been your passion and your life for, well, at least since I've known you, but before then, obviously. Now, let's just mention about Neville Goddard. Oh, by the way, isn't that interesting how you were first introduced to Neville's work via Joe Vitale as well?
Yeah.
Now, one of your programs, Carl, is, if I can mention it, Superlearning the Masters. And what's very interesting, I find, in this, and if you in the audience wants information about this, there'll be links in the show notes. So don't worry. There'll be, just go to the show notes and there'll be links there for you to have a look. But Superlearning the Masters features a strategy which is mind imprint learning through mental photography. And you mentioned this already just in giving us your backstory. What is this mind imprint learning and why is it so effective in helping us do what we want to learn?
Okay, so, back in about late 90s, I did a course and it was called photo reading. And the essence of the course was that you could pick up a book and you could skim through the pages really, really fast. And it would get imprinted into your mind. You would get into a certain state of mind. It would get imprinted into your mind, and then you could recall that information. The reason it was better than just reading a book normally is because it went into your deep unconscious mind. And so I did this course. It was on a weekend. It was on a Saturday. Brilliant course. And I started using that method. And then it was about probably, as much as 8 or 9 years later that I came across a guy on the internet. And what was his course called? I can't remember what it was called, but this guy was the father of photo reading. So he came before photo reading. And I saw some of his videos, and what he discussed was this methodology of absorbing, getting into a photo focus state. So if you bring your attention out like this and you bring it into the peripheral vision, and this is really good for visualizing and imagining and creating as well. What it does is it actually accesses not just the beta state of mind, which is where we are at the moment talking, or maybe we're dipping into alpha, the theta state, which is the spiritual state, and even lower into the delta state. It accesses all of those states of mind at the same time. So whatever you're absorbing in through your eyes is getting like put really into your deep, deep, deep unconscious memory where it's permanently in there. And then if you set a really good goal at the beginning, a really good intention at the beginning as to what you want to do with that information, your unconscious mind starts to serve up little bits of that information at really key moments when you need that information. And it's relevant to achieving your goal. So I really, when I came across these videos this guy was doing, I was like, wow, I got to do my own version of that, because I found that over the past, I think it was before that, about 8 or 9 years, I would go into a bookshop and I would just absorb all of this information and I'd walk out and I'd read about 20 books. And, you know, sometimes I'd buy one if there's quite a lot in there, but often there wasn't that much in each book. So I'd go through about 20 books, get the information I want, imprint it into my mind. And I just would do that with bookshops. So what I decided to do was to take some of the masters, which of the self-help industry, and then to create videos that people could use with the PDF format of the books to imprint like the entire works of some of these masters deep into their unconscious mind. And I started with Neville Goddard. So all of his lectures were out, 3,500 pages of lectures. And then all of his books were about, I think about 500 pages of books. So I created these videos and then I went on and I took other lecturers like about wealth and money, some on marketing, some on the basics of self-help getting started. And I just like really absorbed all of this information into my mind. And it's really, really effective. And I found like the more that I did that, the more it bubbled up inside of me and the more it was at my fingertips. And I still use that if whenever I take on a project. So I adapt very much the Gary Halbert method, which is total absorption into the product that you're going to do some copywriting about, or total absorption into the project that you're working on. So I will take everything that I can get my hands on, and then I will super learn that. So if it's PDFs, then I'll super learn it using the scroll, a particular PDF reader on fast scroll. And I'll absorb that into my mind. Now I find that I can really take on a project really, really fast. So if I'm going to do some writing or emails, I might, you know, just read the entire works of Gary Halbert, all of his Boron letters. Gary, this, for anyone who doesn't know, Gary Halbert's like one of the greatest copywriters in the world. So I'll absorb his entire works into my mind before I actually work on anything. If I'm going to do some work with Neville Goddard, then I'll absorb the entire works of Neville Goddard again, refresh it into my mind again, and it just brings it all up to the surface, puts it all at your fingertips. And then you'll find that when you're working on your self-help, when you're moving forwards, everything just seems to sort of click together. So the reason I created the Superlearning the Masters was to make it more easily available to people, and then to present the works of some of the greatest spiritual teachers all in a really easy to absorb format. So in a week, you could absorb, you know, most of the influential materials that have ever been created in self-help, and it really does work. So, yeah.
Thank you, Carl. And that's an interesting backstory to how you came to get involved in mind imprint learning. I've got it written down in front of me. Excuse me for looking down. Imprint learning through mental photography. You've put together Superlearning the Masters. And I'll tell you what it reminds
me. Let me just mention one more thing. This has come to my mind. Yes. Okay, here's the thing which is really, really interesting and struck me. And this is really key to how everybody learns and how everybody, people are, you know, inherently miseducated as well by media. So when you look at a child, say around something like 3 to 5 years old, children, naturally, you might see them and they're sort of playing around. All of a sudden they go like this and they go into this sort of trance state and their peripheral vision goes out like that and they just absorb everything that's going on. So they might be in a park and they're like looking at all the other kids on the swings and they go into this trance and they stand like that for a minute or so and they're just absorbing it all, and then boom, they go off and they start jumping on stuff. So it's a really, really good habit to have, like method to have at your fingertips. It only takes about 15, 20 minutes to learn. So you can literally go into that trance state. Let's say you're watching a yoga video or you're watching a Pilates video or you're watching some other methodology of something that you want to learn. You literally go into that trance state and it imprints into the mind, like the behaviors and all the intricate details of how somebody is performing some kind of an act. And that is one of the things that the guy's name is Richard Welch, the father of mental photography. And that's one of the things that he observed with actual children. So what we're doing is we're going back to the child mind and we're sitting in the child mind and we're absorbing that information. So, you know, if somebody's a couch potato and they're sitting there and absorbing stuff which is probably not so good for their well-being, it all goes in the same methodology. So it's good to be aware of that. So next time people are sitting here watching a movie, to actually bring themselves out of that photo focus and to try and watch a movie from a conscious perspective, as opposed to where they start at the beginning and then all of a sudden it's over and they're like, oh, what happened? Just wanted to add that. Yeah.
Good addition, Carl, and a very good analogy. I tell you what it reminds me of. The first thing I thought of when doing this mind imprint learning using your own Superlearning the Masters.
Yep.
Was how in the hell am I going to remember any of this? But of course, it's not about consciously remembering. It's you know the movie The Matrix. Who was the main character in The Matrix? Neo, wasn't it?
Neo. That's Neo. One spelt backwards. One. You know, we're all one. Yeah.
didn't even realize that. One spelled backwards.
Neo,
the main character in The Matrix. You remember that scene where he's plugged in and he downloads all that knowledge about self-defense and all the rest of it? It kind of related me in a way to how this super learning technique works. And it's all being downloaded at a high speed into your unconscious memory where it can be retrieved consciously when needed. Very good. I'm going to include a link, if I may, Carl, to your Super Learning the Masters URL if people want to find out more about that. By the way, let's ask right now, because I'm sure somebody watching this will want to know more about what your, because I've got to tell you, and I'm speaking to the audience here, I've looked around a fair bit online. Like Carl said, now, if you've listened to the Joe Vitale interview, as Carl mentioned, that I did with Dr. Joe Vitale, he said that back in the day, learning Neville Goddard's material was kind of like a bit underground. It was not hush-hush, but it wasn't open in the public. And as Carl mentioned, when he came to know and want to get more into Neville Goddard's materials, there were but two websites that he found online, and then the material was costly. So Carl's put his thumbprint on Neville's works and created, and I'll tell you, this is, I'm speaking to the audience member here, Carl, that in my viewing and finding of what's available about Neville Goddard, I haven't found a better source of Neville Goddard's materials and teachings, be it PDFs of his books, of his lectures, of his audio recordings. Carl Bradbrook has it. And if you're interested, if you're curious, and I hope you are, about what Neville Goddard taught, he's long since gone, I think he died in 1972 or something like that, but check out Carl's works on Neville Goddard, and there'll be a link in the show notes. All right, Carl, let's skip forward a bit. So you're the guy who's helping others.
There's something come to mind. I've got to share it, if that's okay, Mike.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's a really nice introduction is the Super Learning the Masters and doing the photo, the mind imprint learning, as I call it, which is the photo imprinting of your mind. Now, what happens, I just want to explain about states. So Neville Goddard introduced me to this concept of states, and every state that we can be in is a complete state of being which already exists. And all we need to do is to shift our consciousness into that state of being. And in that state of being, everything already exists for us to be successful in that state and to lead a happy, joyful life in that state. So there are many states of being that we can embody, and all of these will form together. They come in like frequencies and waves. And so they will form in together to one master wave, which is our consciousness and how we show up in the world. So what I found that happens is that, okay, if somebody wants to learn something new or do something new, which is really prevalent as this, you know, in the environment that we're in at the moment, because people are literally being forced to change, then the best way to do that is by a total immersion, and definitely to use the super learning state, the mind imprint learning state, to pick something in alignment with the higher self. So get aligned to higher self, ask for guidance in life, set an intention, and to follow that intention. And when something comes up as an avenue to walk down, to literally absorb and imprint as much of that information into mind as possible. And what I found with myself that happens is because I'm putting so much information into my unconscious mind, and I'm doing it in a way in which it sits there. I'm doing it with a firm intention. I'm doing it with a good vibration and a good feeling. It triggers a shift of state. Okay? So it literally triggers a shift of state. So all of these states of being exist in consciousness. So if somebody wanted to move from, say, not healthy into healthy, so from sickness into feeling better, to imprint into their minds everything to do with being healthy, right? So to literally just go at it and absorb, follow the, you know, the intuition, absorb as much information as possible. It could be learning some kind of a new exercise routine. It could be a new breathing routine or whatever, to literally absorb and put as much of that as possible into the unconscious mind. What that does is it triggers a shift into the new state. And these new states, Neville Goddard says in one of his lectures, that actually he's mentioned it a few times, that he has met unconditional love, and unconditional love is a man, and he's met these different states of being, and he's known them all to be as a man. And this is very much in alignment with my own experience, because I've had these visions that come into mind and they're in full color, and there's a person in there. And that person, that man, it could be a woman for women. For me, so far, it's been men. That person represents that state, and it contains within it like a, it's like a program, and it triggers something within the unconscious mind. And the unconscious mind downloads that state, as you were mentioning, like in the Matrix, into the mind. And then it's our responsibility to then follow through with that and to absorb it and to assume, as Neville talks about, which is assumption. Whatever you assume will turn into a fact in your life. So to walk the walk, to talk the talk, even if it feels a bit funny, if it feels a bit strange, to start acting like that new person that you want to be, and doing that actually solidifies it. And I've actually had this come into my mind several times where I've been intensely studying something in particular. I went through a couple of years ago studying the Hindu teachings, and I had this vision pop into my mind. It was in full color, and this Hindu guru turned up. And he had like a white, white clothes on and a white, not a turban, but like a, white headgear on. And then all of a sudden, to one side popped up this sort of a gentleman from like the 1800s sort of clothing. And he was about 60 or 70 years old. And then the gentleman switched to a younger version, about 40 years old. And then the whole vision disappeared. And that imprinted my mind and took me on a path then, which I followed and assumed, which was absorbing a whole bunch of the Hindu teachings, which, that's a whole different story. But so there's definite segue from the super learning into the state. So it's as Neville says, it's leaving the old man, let go of the old man and take on the new man. So it's let go of the old self, take on the new self.
Perfect.
Sorry to interrupt you there, but that had to come out.
There's no need to apologise, Carl. What came out was meant to come out, and it did come out at the right time, so we're grateful for that. In my own experience, when I study the more contemporary work, like, for example, Dr. Joe Dispenza and how he talks about the quantum field, and then I go back and study some of Neville Goddard's, for example, just last night and again this morning before this conversation with you, restudying Neville Goddard's, one of his lectures or a chapter from a book on the fourth dimension, which Neville Goddard describes as being time. And it just, the penny drops, oh my goodness, this is quantum, this is the quantum reality, quantum
field. Yeah.
Isn't it? All right, Carl, so you're also a coach, so you've got all this past experience, you've been through adversity and more than once to make a comeback, as you say, and you've been on this journey of self-discovery and personal development, which you remain on, and you've been filling your unconscious mind through the mind imprint learning. So you've got all this wisdom within you, knowledge, experience, and wisdom, those three powerful things combined. And you bring all this to help others, which means you are a coach. You are a coach. There's a link on your website, coaching. Who's the ideal person that you're coaching? Who's the person who's likely to get the most from working with Carl Bradbrook?
Okay, so people turn up, generally they're stuck in one way or another. A lot of people turn up through my Neville Goddard products, and then some people turn up out of the blue. Okay, so they've really hit, in terms of Neville stuff, a lot of people turn up and they say, well, I'm imagining, but it's not working. Things aren't showing up, or they've got some kind of blocks showing up in their life in terms of experiences that they're having. It might be traumatic experiences. It might be experiences that they're having that they don't want to have. It's like, well, I've been studying this self-help for X amount of years and the law of attraction and all these people, and it just doesn't work. I can't make it work and blah, blah, blah. And so that's the general sort of idea. The age group, it can be anything between, I guess, around, I had someone recently around sort of 30 years old up to 70-ish, 75-ish. I've coached people as, in that age group as well. People turn up for coaching when the wheels have fallen off in one way or another, and then they're unable to make a breakthrough. So a lot of it comes from ego. So on the planet at the moment, we've got what I call the global ego crisis. So everybody's in ego and they're
giggling. I love it. That's the copywriter in you coming through. I love that. Excuse me, I'm not being flippant in, I know that's very serious, but I love the phrase.
Yeah, so it really is. It's the global ego crisis. So this is really what's happening. And the call to action is the call to the higher self. It's what I call the return of the king. So when people turn up for my coaching with me, it's really to meet the king. Essentially, it's to meet the higher self. The higher self has got something that they haven't been listening to. It's got the keys to the, the kingdom, and the way out of the maze. So it's.
Can I just pause?
Yeah, go.
There,
yeah.
Can I just ask a question and please come back? So bookmark where you are. Let's just be in the mind of somebody who's listening or viewing you now, and they hear you, they are at that point of the wheels falling off. Okay. Let's just talk to this person. And they hear you use the word king and kingdom, and it's not what we say, it's what people hear that matters. That's the subtitle of a book, Words That Work. And they hear king and kingdom, and what they're hearing is, oh, he's going to go Bible on me. He's going to Bible bash me. What's your answer to that? Because I'm sure somebody might think that.
Okay. My answer, there's a lot of people who think that. And they don't want to hear anything religious at all. So the answer to that is that to focus on the higher self, there is a higher, there's some kind of a, this comes from AA, of course, and all of the 12-step programs, some kind of a power that a person can believe in that is greater than themselves. In the Hindu tradition, they call it the Atman. You can call it the God self. You can call it your higher self. You can call it your spirit. You can call it your soul. You can call it the higher levels of your own consciousness. So it's that element of us which is non-physical. It's the element of us which is projecting us into this physical reality. So it's also like it's the inner child. So it's that part of us that is there going, please wake up. Please listen to what I've got to say at some point, because I know I can guide you out of where you're at right now if you'll only listen to me. Right, so it's that part of ourselves, the quiet whisper, the inspiration. It's the, the guiding light which leads us out of the dark night of the soul, which is the ego's misery. Yeah.
So to become spiritual under the guidance of Carl Bradbrook's coaching and teaching doesn't mean that Carl's going to say, and the only way this is going to work for you is if you go to a physical building called a church every Sunday morning. Although that's not excluded, if that's what somebody wants to do, I'm sure. I don't want to put words in your own mouth, Carl, but that's not to be discounted. But that's not a part of what you're teaching, is it, in spirituality?
No, but okay. So look, the church is in us. The temple of God is within us. So I met a guy one time years ago, and I was down at the beach, and this old guy walked up to me, and he was about, I don't know, about 90 years old or something like that. And coincidentally, I'd been studying about youth and age and taking back the years the locusts have eaten. And this guy walks up to me, and I was there with my girlfriend, and he had a little bit of English, and he pointed at my girlfriend's heart, and he said, "God is in there. God is in there." Right. So he's talking to like this God self within. Look, the temple of God is within. We carry it around. We walk around. I think it was William Blake that Neville refers to a lot. What's everybody doing? Looking out, calling upon this God out there when all they need to do is look within themselves, right? Because the answer is within. And it doesn't matter what religion you study. It doesn't matter what religion you sign up to. They all talk about this same essence of God within ourselves, and a lot of the, well, all of the New Age materials as well. So yes, look, go to a mosque. Yes, go to a church. Yes, go to meditation groups, retreats, meetings with like-minded people, Osho, dance around and, shaking and whatever it is. Yes, do all of that, because, wherever there's more than one person gathered and whatever gives you a really good feeling in your heart, do that. But then behind all of that is the mechanics of it. And this is like God's laws. And this is what Neville talks about, the law and the promise. Yes. So first of all, became God's laws. And then comes the promise, where God became man to have the experience to experience itself, because there's only one being in this entire universe. You and I are just facets. We're individualized consciousness within this one being that many call God. All right. So yeah, get into that higher vibration, that higher state of mind, and ask for guidance. How do you connect with God? How do you connect with your higher self? How do you connect with your spirit? You can just literally close your eyes, surrender, take a deep breath, focus on your heart as a gateway, focus on your crown chakra as a gateway, and just say, "I'm connecting to my higher self. I'm connecting to my God. I'm connecting to my God of my understanding. I'm connecting to my soul. I'm connecting to my spirit. I'm connecting to my higher levels of consciousness." And then you can say, "I'm connected," and you feel that connection. And then ask for guidance. Ask for more. More of everything.
Yes, and apologies for interrupting you, and I don't know whether you've already covered what you had bookmarked at the point where I interrupted you when you referred to king and kingdom. It's interesting when you say ask. While I don't consider myself religious, I've read the Bible from cover from first book to last book twice. Apparently only 30% of self-professed Christians even pick up the Bible and read it, so I've heard. But so anyway, what I'm reminded of is Matthew chapter 7:7, ask and you shall receive, seek and you shall find, knock and you shall find. The acronym from ask, seek and knock is ask. And so that to me is that asking is so important. By no coincidence. By the way, I can't take credit, because that's an inspired thought I had. And by no coincidence, not by coincidence, by no coincidence, Carl, you just mentioned and focused on the importance of asking. Look, time always flies fast when you're having fun, and already our time is almost up, and I'm very respectful of your time, Carl, but I just sense we've only scratched the surface, and I don't know what your schedule would be like in the remainder of 2021 or maybe into 2022. If we could meet again and go deeper into another conversation, is that at all possible?
Absolutely love to, and let's do it in 21 if you've got room in your schedule as well, because I think the timing is so relevant now for everyone to wake up. It's there for everybody. The higher self is calling. The keys of the kingdom of heaven is our inner world, right? And nothing there's this illusion that goes on. Everybody thinks that they're out here in the world, they're doing stuff in the world. Nothing is created in the world outside before it is created within ourselves. So the methodology of creation is to have a line to higher self, have an intention, energize that intention with imagining and visualization, and then take inspired action, which is walking in the assumption that whatever it is that you want, you already have. So you act as if, even if you feel it feels fake or false or whatever at the beginning, and then clearing any blocks that come up in the interim. So the kingdom of heaven is this inner territory. It's our minds, and always mind is first. So most people are looking for a healing. A healing is the consequence. People are looking for prosperity. Prosperity is a consequence. They're looking for the perfect partner. It's a consequence. They're looking for a new business. It's a consequence. It's an effect. First of all is mind. And mind is the kingdom within. Okay, so I just wanted to sum up on that. So yeah, anytime you want to have a talk, I'm really, really happy to have a talk. And I will be, I'll just mention this. So for anyone who goes to my website, I have got a training on there called The Game of Life. It's free to sign up for. I've been told like it's too long to give people as an introductory piece of information, because it's about 11 and a half hours of information there. So I'm going to do something a little bit shorter, but at the moment you can go along and dive into what I call the game of life. And it's all about the higher self. It's all about ego. And it gives people like an idea of life, which is not what they've been sold currently. Even you know, if they've been on the self-development trail, the game of life will connect all the dots and give people a fuller picture as to what is going on. So yeah, that's kind of like a doorway where we can people can communicate. So yeah, it's really, really key to connect with the higher self. All right, it's really, really key. There's a lot going on. I just want to mention this because this is interesting. I was reading in the comments of a video that I saw maybe a week or so ago, and there's a lady, she was talking about she was in nature walking. Nature is great. And she said she felt the like this energy start to come up through the soles of her feet, and it rose up through her body and through her chakras, the base chakra, and it rose up, and then she had this like to her third eye and her crown chakra, and she like had this feeling of connection. And then I was driving down the road the other day, I saw somebody I knew, pulled over, ladies started doing yoga. And she said to me, oh, you know, when I'm doing yoga, she said, I got a bit scared, and I was sitting there, and she said, my body started shaking, and she started shaking in the belly area. And then she started shaking in the heart area. And my message to her was like, this is fantastic stuff, because what is happening is this like global awakening going on. So the energy that flows up is the Kundalini, and this Kundalini energy is flowing up in individuals, and it is opening them to the higher levels of consciousness. So what we're going to see as things move forwards over the next ensuing years is more and more of this, like these spontaneous experiences of higher levels of consciousness being experienced by people out of the blue. And my greatest thought for people would be that they begin the journey. They ask to connect with their higher self. They ask to connect with their God self, and they open themselves. They open the door. It's like opening the door to God, right? Opening the door to their higher consciousness. Yeah. So yeah. I just wanted to mention that. Yeah.
Thank you, Carl. I think that, okay, let's do it. Let's decide now that before the end of the year, you and I will meet again for another conversation on the Comeback Coach podcast. And I think that's the ideal subject to start off with, is how to begin that, how to connect with the higher self. And you're the right guy to be leading and coaching and teaching our audience and also your own private clients on how to do that. I know that, Carl, so the URL, the link that Carl's mentioned to the Game of Life, I'll include that in the show notes, so you, the audience member watching or listening to this replay, only need to go to the show notes and there'll be a link there. I also know that if you want to know just a bit more about Carl, if your interest has been piqued, if you're curious, or if you want to dive in, go to carlbradbrook.com, start there. There'll be numerous links that you can click on to know more about Carl, and there'll be a contact me kind of a link where you can make contact with Carl, and we're going to meet again. You know, Carl, here's what comes to mind. The audience member has numerous options on where to get this stuff from.
Right? Yeah.
There's books and there's authors going back hundreds of years. More recently, yeah, in the last 100 years, whether it's someone like Joseph Murphy, Neville Goddard, more contemporary, Joe Vitale, Dr. Joe Dispenza. I mean, there's numerous people you can go to. First of all, chances are if you get one of their books, of these other authors, chances are you won't read the whole book. Chances are you won't get past the first chapter. Now, that's painful to hear it, but that's the truth if you think about it. I mean, how many books have I got on my shelf at home in Australia that I haven't even got past chapter one? There's more than one. So that brings me to another thing. And I'm going to say this, that there are pretenders in this industry, if you want to call it that, this coaching industry in spirituality, those who are preaching from knowledge only. There's no experience, and therefore there's no wisdom. With this guy, Carl Bradbrook, knowing what I know, there's knowledge, there's painful experience, and let me tell you. Hey, am I right, Carl?
Absolutely. It's the journey, right?
Talk about
it. And it gets better.
It does get better. But you and I know, Carl, the painful experience that we've gone through for our own personal comebacks. And so when you've got somebody who has knowledge through study, painful experience, you've got wisdom. Now, Carl Bradbrook is a genuine guy. He's not a pretender. And he's the guy that I would recommend you go to if you want to expand your awareness and do the things that Carl can help you do, become the person you want to become, get the things you want most from life, and continue on a happier, more serene person. Carl, I am so grateful to you, my friend, for joining here on this podcast, giving us some of your time, sharing some of your wisdom, making yourself available again later in the year when we'll do this again. Do you have any last parting thoughts before we go?
Yeah, I want to give you a parting thought from Neville Goddard, and it's called The Pearl of Great Price. Okay, so the story goes like this. There was a merchant, and he had all these different things that he was trading, you know, maybe he had some gold and silver and cattle and whatever, and he had all, and he came into a market and he saw this beautiful pearl. And it was just a single pearl, absolutely beautiful, most beautiful thing they'd ever seen. And he sold everything that he had, absolutely everything that he had, and he bought this one pearl. And it was called The Pearl of Great Price. So this is a story from the greatest metaphysical book in existence, as Neville Goddard calls it, aka the Bible. So what is The Pearl of Great Price? The Pearl of Great Price is the imagination. And everything begins with imagination. There is nothing that has been created in this world that didn't first begin in the mind of man. So imagination is the cause, and it doesn't matter what you've done in your life, whether it's good or bad, what you've experienced, it first began in imagination. So Pearl of Great Price, whatever teachings that people come across, teach people how to go within and use their divine, their wonderful, connect with their higher self, allow that inner guidance to flow through, and to use their imagination first inside of them in the kingdom of heaven within to create the reality that they want. They're going to find that whatever they want in the world starts to show up. So the teachings which teach a person to align to their higher self, their higher levels of consciousness, and then to begin the process of creation within themselves, that is going to get results.
Good. Better than good. terrific imagination keyword there from Carl. Carl, yep. Thank you once again, and thanks again for joining us. And to you, the listener, or to the viewer, thank you for joining us. Thank you for joining this conversation with Carl Bradbrook. And until next we meet on the Comeback Coach podcast, this is Mike Searles signing off.